Welcome back to Smart Investment YouTube channel. Today I would like to share detailed analysis video on the company Indian Hotels Company Limited. IHCL is a Tata Group company which is operational in 10 plus countries and 125 plus locations. In total, it has 80 plus spas, 260 plus hotels, 430 plus restaurants and 3100 rooms to serve its customer. Its brand portfolio includes Taj, Vivanta, Ginger Hotels, Amastays and Trails and Taj Sets. Its chain of food and beverages includes Golden Dragon, Shamiana, House of Lomad, Mashan, House of Ming, Seven Rivers Brewing Company, Southern Spice, Bombay Brasserie, Thai Pavilion, Paper Moon and Loya. Taj is ranked the strongest brand in India across the sectors and industry by Brand Finance in 2023, 2022 and 2020. Company's financial analysis are as below. Current market price ₹436, 52 week high ₹450, 52 week low ₹280.05. Company's dividend yield is 0.23%, ROCE 13.22%, BVPS is 60.8. Company's sales is 1433 crore, debt to equity 0.1, PE ratio 45.94, EPS ₹7.06, PB ratio 7.79. Market capital 62,182 crores, face value ₹10. Company's net sales was ₹1,433 crore in September 2023, up 16.27%. Quarterly net profit is at ₹166.92 crore in September 2023, up 37.31%. And EBITDA stands at ₹402.45 crore in September 2023, up 26.18% as compared to September 2020. Its EPS has increased to ₹1.18 in March 2023 from ₹0.86 in March 2022. IHCL has further strengthened its presence with 400-room Taj-branded hotel at Indira Gandhi's International Airport Terminal in New Delhi. Company has recently opened The Crown in Bhubaneswar, which is inspired by the cultural heritage of Odisha and is located in the heart of Bhubaneswar. Its first hotel is in Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir, Vivanta Jammu, which offers a panoramic view of the Himalayas. The company recently announced its partnership with Tata Strive for a hospitality-focused skill center at Umaid Bhavan Palace, Jodhpur, which aimed at nurturing talent from economically weaker and socially disadvantaged local communities. The company recently signed its opening of Vivanta branded hotel in Guwahati, Assam, which is estimated to be opened by 2026, and the second is Taj Gandhinagar Resort and Spa in Gujarat. The company has also announced its sustainability commitment for the year 2030 under Pathya, which will be starting from elimination of plastic straws, replacing plastic wrap dry amenities with eco-friendly substitutes, introduction of bottling plants to initiating zero single-use plastic hotels in the country. Rambagh Palace, Jaipur has been rated world's number one hotel in coveted 2023 Traveler's Choice Awards by TripAdvisor, which is the world's largest travel site. The company has recently announced the signing of its Silocutions branded hotel in Indore, Madhya Pradesh, whereas a Vivanta branded hotel in New Gurugram, Haryana. Company recently announced its landmark hotel, that is the Taj Mahal Palace, Mumbai, is now 100% green. Its drive is to minimize its environmental impact. In addition to using renewable energy, has also implemented water conservation and waste reduction measures. Company's iconic Taj hit a century as it announced its 100th Taj hotel after signing its second Taj hotel in Kochi. Company has also announced the signing of its two new hotel under Vivanta and Ginger brand in Ayodhya, Uttar Pradesh. The company also opened the Yellow House Anjuna, an IHCL Silocutions hotel in Goa. It is nestled in the lively neighborhood of Anjuna. It is carefully restored hotel which blends traditional Goan Portuguese style with modern luxury. India's travel and tourism revenue is projected to show an annual growth rate of CAGR 13.59% and projected to reach a market volume of $31.35 billion by 2027. The company has a strong portfolio of 191 operating hotels under its different brands and another 79 hotels in pipeline as on June 2023. Mutual fund holding have increased by 0.8% in last quarter to 22.3% and its debt by equity ratio is 0.1, which is very less and shows healthy financial positions. In last 3 years, the stock gave a return of 271.25% as compared to rise of Sensex and Nifty in the same period. Thank you for watching video with us. If you find this video interesting, please like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel.